in the hip.
Boy.
That dipped 2 feet.
He can't catch for the Jays, that's for sure.
Not last year, anyway. Alex Edler from center ice. First shot of the game, and we'll see how that affects Brian Elliott moving forward. That's got to rattle you just a little bit, don't you think?
Across the ice. Three times here across the ice. Three in a row. And when you move that puck laterally like that, sooner or later, someone's going to get open. And you see Kopitar, he doesn't get all of it. He doesn't. And Edroff is there, but because it's a knuckleball changeup, Edroff can't get a beat on it.
Even have a sturdy stick to put it away with. And the knuckleballer, the slow off pitch, the half shot is the one that finally beats Lehtinen, who has been very strong in this hockey game.
Play, no question. Thornton's going in front. Burns misses his shot. And you can see it just flutters into the net because Jonathan Quick is so aggressive and he just slides by this. That's one of the dangers if you're that aggressive. And at that point, there's no way that Jonathan Quick can make the return back to the center of the net.
On an outnumbered attack is Corey Perry for the winner. He scores! And the Ducks win it in overtime, 2-1.
Good sorting out by the Kings here to put it to the outside, but Perry has so much time to just lean in. No, it was. I was right the first time. It did knuckle. You could see it flutter, you could see it go, and you could see Quick react. It was almost like a changeup.
The little looper here, as it's a knuckle puck, goes high and right over. And look at the reaction at the back end by Weidman. I mean, he just buries his head. The puck's rolling, and it dropped about 4.5 feet from start to finish, right over the shoulder of Emelin, and then down over the...
He allowed 3 goals on 7 shots in his last outing. He got pulled from the game.
And here, a knuckler goes over a stick, and I think it goes right off the glove. Doesn't hit that stick. It's just a knuckling shot. It went right over it.
The Kings were so good moving the puck. Look at LeCavalier. He has his stick cocked for such a long period of time. I think the passer, Jamie McBain, there saying, I've got to make the pass. And this goes against the flow. Well, it's a knuckleball.
But watch the stick of Chara. It hits the top of his stick, and then just an absolute duck down in between a startled Tuukka Rask. I don't think I've ever seen one go that high and then that low so quickly.
Anderson shoots this puck. Yeah, it's on edge and it's a knuckler. Great pickup by our crew. Corey Crawford trying to find this into his glove and it goes right by him.
Depth scoring for Detroit. Versus the fourth line with Eves, and right there, Joachim Andersen, the third center.
It's up on end, and it dove away from Foss, who's deep in his net, allowed that curve to play him. Look at the puck up on end. Look at that thing move. Wow. This is perfect in slow motion. It's going dead on the crest of Victor Foss, and it beats him low on the glove side.
Bouncy goal is... Zotto had the puck bounce in the net. Puck winds up in the net, but offside call. A sinker from center ice beats Grubauer, but offside was whistled.
That was Radko Gudas's range. He loves those long shots. It hit a stick when he let it go, and it had to drop 3 feet. There's the hit stick, and it just dropped.
Coots offside is my guess. I didn't see anybody jumping the Flyer bench. Right at this bottom of the screen. Oh, yeah.
Just.
This puck gets past Patrick Kane. The shot. Not sure if Crawford gets a piece of it or not, but Pominville all by himself. A rolling puck off the post and in.
Now, Scandella can bring serious heat. The knuckleball effect on the puck and the crazy carom off the backboard.
Krejci spins on. See that thing fluttering, and then I think Lundqvist puts that in himself, yep. Dave, with Horton going at him. Horton's stick never gets there. Delzato ties up Horton's stick, but it's the knuckleball effect of the puck from Chara that fools Lundqvist and finally.